Hello and welcome students. Today in this video we shall practice about using of the proper forms of verb, using proper tense of the verb to fill up the blanks. In the last two videos I taught you how to use present tense and how to use past tense. So now let us have a practice. The sentence number one is the thief blank hide is the verb that will be used behind a tree to see the police. Here we see that there is the thief who himself hid somewhere to see the police, or on seeing the police there are two actions. He watches the police and after watching the police he takes an action, or you can say both the actions are taken simultaneously, but the action one is there to see the police. He at first looked at the police and then he hid himself. So here we shall use hid. He hid himself, the thief hid himself behind a tree to see the police. Next sentence. He usually is the word that shows about the frequent habit or some acquaintance habits of a person. He usually blank speak English fluently. So this is regarding about the skill of a person who is using it frequently. So it shall be used of a speaks. He speaks present indefinite tense. He speaks English fluently. Next sentence. It blank rain when we blank reach the home. Then there are two actions. One action is of about raining and the second action about reaching of a home. So if in one part of the sentence we use past indefinite, in the other part of the sentence we can use past continuous also. So here it will be it was raining. It was raining when we reached the home. Next sentence. Don't disturb me, imperative sentence. Don't disturb me, I blank do my homework. It means to say present tense here, so it will be also in the present tense. So don't disturb me, I am doing, present continuous, I am doing my homework. Next sentence. Whenever she blank visit Agra, she blank go to see the Taj. This is about the habit of the subject she, habit of the past. So it will be whenever she visited Agra, she blank go to see the Taj. So she went to see the Taj. She went to see the Taj, habit of the past. Okay. My son, next sentence, blank finish his assignment while his mother blank cook. There are two actions, parallel actions. To express two parallel actions of the past, we may use past indefinite in both the sentences, or we may use in one part past indefinite and in the other part past continuous. So let us see what happens here. My son finished his assignment. So it will be appropriate to use past indefinite. My son finished his assignment while his mother cooked. So here we may use past indefinite. So here my son finished his assignment and while his mother cooked the food. In both the part we used past indefinite. Next sentence is he blank go to Karnal next month. Here this is regarding the use of a planned task next month. The task will take place in the next month. So to express the near future or a fixed action, we may express it by using present indefinite also. So we may use he goes to Karnal next month. Here we may use future indefinite also, he will go to Karnal next. Now let's take some more sentences. They blank play here since 5 o'clock this morning. If you find in any of the sentences time mentioned in the end of the sentence and along with the time since or for, in those sentences we use perfect continuous tense. So in this sentence we shall use present perfect continuous. They have been playing here. So they have been playing. They have been playing here since 5 o'clock this morning. We used here present tense because of this morning, present time, present perfect continuous. Next sentence. An honest man blank speak the truth always. This is indicating towards the habit of a person, and we know that honest people speak truth. Because of honest man, here it is in singular form, so we shall use here present indefinite. So present indefinite needs s or es with the verb if subject is in singular form. So here we shall use speaks. An honest man speaks the truth always. Next sentence. Newton blank discover the laws of gravitation. So here this is about the historical fact or the historical truth, and to report about any of the incident related to history we use past indefinite. So here discovered, Newton discovered the laws of gravitation. Next sentence. Mr. Advani visit America last month, last week, last year, last day, yesterday, previous day. All these sentences indicate towards the past, and to express simple past we use a past indefinite. So here Mr. Advani visited America last month. Next sentence. I blank read the Gita already. Any of the activity that has already taken place already indicates about the same. So I have read. I have read. I have read the Gita already. Now the next sentence. My friend said that C blank prepare for IAS. Here in this sentence we see that this is in indirect speech. Said, indicating when the reporting verb is in past tense, then the tense of the reported speech also changes. So we see my friend said that C blank prepare for IAS. It is telling something continuous process of preparing. So was preparing. C was preparing for IAS. Actually in direct speech this sentence was in present continuous. She was preparing in past tense when we change it into indirect speech. Okay. Haryana blank come into existence in 1966. 1966 is the year that is telling us something about the historical fact. For example, India got liberty in 1947. Gandhiji died in 1948. India's constitution came into existence in 1950. All these dates, all these indication of time are expressed by using past indefinite. So here we shall use came. Haryana came into existence in 1966. So we practiced here 15 sentences of English. We used different tenses to ensure our accuracy. If you liked this video, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the like button also. Thank you very much.